Hello students, today we are going to discuss about next topic of this chapter, and that is dihybrid cross experiment. In previous lecture we have already discussed about monohybrid cross experiment, and today we are going to discuss about dihybrid cross experiment. So here first of all let me discuss about the meaning of dihybrid cross experiment. Here di means two. Okay, so inheritance of two genes, if it is observed during the experiment, then it is considered as a dihybrid cross experiment. Okay, so when it is considered as a dihybrid cross experiment, when inheritance of two genes. Okay, in monohybrid cross experiment, we have observed about inheritance of one genes. Okay, but here what happened? Two genes inheritance will be observed during whole experiment, and that's why it is called dihybrid cross experiment, and which is carried out by Mendel. Okay, so it is a cross between two parents having difference in the two pair of contrasting character. Okay, suppose for example we can take it as an example, a cross between pea plant having a round shaped and yellow colored seed. Okay, so here you can see this is a round color, round shape and the yellow color seed. Okay, that having RRYY means round itself is a dominant gene. Okay, homozygous for the dominant, then yellow color is also dominant on the other color. Okay, so here a dominant, both are dominant pairs are there. Capital RR, capital YY, both are dominant. One is dominant for the round shape of this pea plant. Okay, and then a yellow color seeds. Okay, so both are dominant. Next characteristic here you can see wrinkle shaped. This one is a wrinkle shape and color is a green. So for wrinkle shape there is a small RR gene, and that is a recessive gene, and for the green color itself is a recessive gene. We have already discussed about seven contrasting character of the Mendel's pea. Okay, so we have already remember about this, which are the contrasting characters. So green color is a recessive in presence of a yellow color. So here you can see small RR and YY is taken. So here crossing over occur in between capital RRYY and this wrinkle green, that means small RR and YY. That means round yellow seeds is crossed with the wrinkle greens. Okay, so this is the experiment. Now let me start understanding what is the dihybrid cross and what happened during this. So here you know parents having homozygous round yellow, okay, and genotype will be capital RR and YY, right? Okay, and here second parent which is a homozygous but having wrinkle and green, that means recessive traits. So here this one is a homozygous recessive and here homozygous dominant. So now you know very well when these parent will form gametes, and if it is forming gametes, then all gametes will have capital R and Y. Okay, so this gamete will have capital R and Y. There is only possibility of this. Okay, and here if these parent form any kind of gamete, then it will be have a gamete with small r and Y. Okay, so small r and Y containing gamete will be there. Okay, so now this is the gamete from this parent and this is the gamete from this parent. Now what happened? This is a sexual reproduction, and that's why fusion of these two gametes will be occur, and as a result of fuse of these two gametes, what happens? Zygote formation will occur. Okay, and it will result into first filial generation. So first filial generation will have capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Okay, and you know very well here a heterozygous, and here small r will be suppressed, small y will be suppressed, and as a result of that F1 generation will have round and yellow seeds. Okay, you can understand here because this is a small r, in presence of this capital R it will be suppressed. Okay, this Y which is responsible for green color, it will also suppress in presence of Y, that is a capital Y, and that is responsible for yellow color. And as a result of that, in the F1 generation, there will be round and yellow seeds. So you must be remember here, a round and yellow seeds will be obtained. Okay, now what happened? This F1 generation will be allowed for the selfing. Okay, as a result, you can see here, this is the F1 generation seeds. This is also F1 generation seeds. Both are heterozygous. Okay, you have already done this type of experiment during the monohybrid cross. So F1 generation will be selfed. Okay, here this is a dihybrid cross. So here you have written two type of genes. That is the only difference. Okay, but here there is a gamete formation having the four possibilities. Whereas in case of a monohybrid cross, there is only two possibilities of gametes. Okay, so this is the difference. So you must be remember the difference between dihybrid and monohybrid. Here gamete chances or a possibility will be 4. You can see here, this R, Y, both are capital, both are dominant, one recessive, one dominant, and both recessive. These are the 4 chances in the gamete formation. So you must be remember. So here, after selfing in the F1 generation, 4 type of gamete will be formed. So here also 4 type of gamete will be formed, and here also 4 type of gamete will be formed. So now let me see what will be occur. So this is the Punnett square analysis. Okay, as you have done in the monohybrid cross, here also you have to write down on the column, okay, on the upper side, in the sides, okay, here a female gamete and here the male gamete, or vice versa we can do. Okay, so here is the female gamete suppose, and this is the male gamete. So what will be the result into F2 generation? So you can see the combinations. Okay, so this gamete will fuse with this one and it will result into round yellow seeds. Okay, these gamete will fuse with this one, then it will be responsible for round yellow further, but having genotype having capital RR and YY. Here Y is a small. Okay, so you should remember. So here if these two gamete is fused together, then round yellow seed will be there. Then further, if these gamete fuse with this one, then this is the result. This is also a result into round yellow phenotype, and genotype will be capital R, small r, and both will be capital Y. Okay, then further, these genes also fuse with this one. Okay, this gamete, if it is fused with this one, then it is resulting, this phenotype will be round yellow. Okay, so here you can see capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So accordingly, you can check this all. Okay, so 16 type of possibilities will be there. Okay, so as this is the 4 gametes, 4 possibilities of gamete, there is a 4 possibility of female and male gametes, both. So here total offspring, maybe the possible offspring will be 16, and that all will include a phenotype. Here you can see this is a phenotype, 4 type of phenotype will be obtained. Round yellow, okay, this is the dominant, totally dominant. Here one character will be of dominant and one character will be of recessive. Okay, you know very well, round shape is the dominant one and green one is the recessive one. So here mixture, okay, one is a dominant and one is a recessive. Here one is a recessive, one is a dominant. Okay, and here both will be recessive. Here you can see the last table, last box. Okay, so these all are the possibilities, and you must be remember how it is possible. Okay, which type of, you can see here 4 type of phenotype will be obtained after this generation. Okay, so in this generation, in the F2 generation, you will get 4 type of phenotype. Okay, and here you can see all type of genotypes. So let me understand what will be get, we will get the genotype. Okay, you know very well 4 type of phenotype we will get, but let me discuss about the genotype. What will be the genotype ratio? So on observing F2, Mendel found that the yellow and the green color segregated into 3:1 ratio. Here also segregation ratio will be 3:1, but here what you have to do, you have to bracket it and hold rest to square. Okay, so if you release this whole rest to square, then you will get 9:3:3:1. Okay, this is the phenotypic ratio, not a genotypic, right? So this is the phenotypic ratio. Here you can see, if you calculate this round and yellow, then 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So you will get 9 seeds which will have round and yellow, that is a totally dominant characters. Both character will be dominant. So here you can see the ratio 9. Then here a purple color you can see, this is a round and green. Okay, so 1, 2 and 3. 3 will, you will observe round and green. Okay, so here written 3. And then further you can see here, okay, this one, this greenish color, this one, 1, 2 and 3, wrinkled and yellow. Okay, so wrinkled and yellow is also 3. And then further here you can see in these last boxes, this one is a wrinkle and green, that is exactly similar to the parent. Okay, and totally recessive. So that is a ratio of 1. So this ratio can be derived as a combination series of 3 yellow, 1 green, as you have found in the Mendel's monohybrid cross experiment with the 3 round and the 1. Okay, so this is the in between, you can see 3:1, 3:1, both will be multiplied, and if you release this, you will get 9:3:3:1. And accordingly, you can do with the trihybrid cross also. Okay, so you have to try it at the your home as a homework. What will happen in the trihybrid cross experiment? Okay, so do this activity at your home. So this is the case in which you can see 3:1, 3:1, 2 times, because here dihybrid cross. Okay, so you will get 9:3:3:1. This is a phenotypic ratio. Till that, we have not understanding about the genotype, right? So let me discuss that. So on observing F2, Mendel found that the yellow and the green color segregated in 3:1 ratio, that is exactly same as the monohybrid cross. Okay, and round and wrinkled sheet shape also segregated in 3:1. Okay, both well separated or segregated into 3:1 ratio. Okay, but here you can see, okay, which type of you can get the genotype. So this you have to remember like this. So capital RY, capital RY, both will be only one. Okay, then here you can cross this one. Okay, you will get capital RR, capital RR, and capital Y, small y. Okay, so that type of genotype you will get two. So 1:2, 2:4, 1:2, 2:1. Okay, so you have to remember this phenotype. Phenotype you know very well, 9:3:3:1. But this is the genotype. Okay, so this phenotype related characteristic is depend on this genotype. Okay, so you must be remember here one, this box having one, this box having two. Then further here you can see this structure is calculated. Okay, this structure is calculated. This is avoided. Okay, so this is a two further. Then four, capital R R Y Y is the four. Okay, then one. Okay, and then further two, one, two, and one, like that. So you must be remember this genotype in this experiment, dihybrid cross experiment. Now I am giving you an activity. Okay, you have to prepare one Punnett square for this combination. Okay, just you have to prepare Punnett square. This is the dihybrid cross experiment, you can understand, because here two alleles are given. Okay, so two alternative alleles are given. So you have to do the Punnett square analysis for this, and finally you have to identify genotypic and phenotypic ratio. Okay, do this work in your notebook fast. Okay, write down genotypic and phenotypic ratio in the comment, and I am giving you 3 minutes for this activity. Your time start now. Here in this slide you can see one MCQ, and that is based on dihybrid cross experiment. Okay, and that you have to solve now. Okay, and for that I will give you 2 minutes. Just solve it out and write down your answer in a comment. Your time start now. So this is your homework for today's lecture, and before we finish this lecture, let me summarize whole topic by using one animation video. So look at this video.
Gregor Mendel cultivated and tested about 29,000 pea plants between 1856 and 1863. One such test was the crossing of pea plants with yellow and round seeds and those with green and wrinkled seeds. As you know, such a cross between plants that differ in two traits or characters is known as a dihybrid cross. This experiment, conducted by Mendel, resulted in a pea plant that produced yellow and round seeds in the F1 generation. Here, can you guess the dominant shape and color? Obviously, the round shape is dominant over the wrinkled shape, and the yellow color dominant over green. Mendel noticed that these results were identical to the results he had obtained when he had carried out monohybrid crosses between plants with round and wrinkled seeds and those with yellow and green seeds. Now, in Mendel's dihybrid experiment, let's denote the dominant yellow seed color with the genotypic symbol capital Y and the recessive green seed color with small y. Likewise, let's denote the round seed as capital R and the wrinkled seed as small r. The genotype of the parents can therefore be denoted as capital R, capital R, capital Y, and small r, small y. On crossing the plants, the gametes capital R, capital Y, and small y unite to produce yellow and round seeds with the genotype capital R, capital Y, small y in the F1 generation. Mendel further self-pollinated the plants obtained in the F1 generation to produce F2 generation plants. This time, he found that 3/4 of the seeds were yellow, while 1/4 was green. Similarly, he noticed that 3/4 of the seeds were round, while 1/4 was wrinkled. Therefore, the yellow and green color had segregated in the ratio 3:1, similar to the results obtained in a monohybrid cross. And the round and wrinkled shape had segregated in the same ratio 3:1. Mendel also found that the phenotypic ratio in the F2 hybrid was 9:3:3:1. That is, there were 9 round yellow seeds, 3 round green seeds, 3 wrinkled yellow seeds, and 1 wrinkled green seed. Mendel had got the same phenotypic ratio in several dihybrid experiments that he had conducted. This ratio, 9:3:3:1, can be derived as a combination series of 3 yellow:1 green with 3 round:1 wrinkled. And further, this derivation can be written as shown. From such observations on dihybrid crosses, Mendel proposed a new set of generalizations, which was later called the law of independent assortment. According to this law, when 2 pairs of traits or characters are united in a hybridization experiment, the segregation of one pair of characters is independent of the other pair of characters. We can use the Punnett square to easily understand the independent segregation of the 2 genes during meiosis and the production of pollen grains and eggs in the F1 generation. For example, In the dihybrid cross experiment conducted by Mendel, the genotype of the seed obtained in the F1 generation was capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Now, let's consider the segregation of one pair of genes, capital R and small r. Here, 50% of the gametes have the capital R gene, and the remaining 50% have the small r gene. Now, apart from each gamete having either capital R or small r, it must also have either capital Y or small y. Here, it is important to note that the segregation of 50% capital R and 50% small r is different from the segregation of 50% capital Y and 50% small y. Hence, 50% of the gametes bearing small r has capital Y, and the remaining 50% has small y. Similarly, 50% of the gametes bearing capital R has capital Y, and the remaining 50% has small y. Therefore, the genotypes of the gametes are of four types, namely capital R capital Y, capital R small y, small r capital Y, and small r small y. In other words, there are four types of eggs and four types of pollen. And as you can see, the frequency of these gametes is 25% or 1/4 of the total number of gametes produced. Now, the allelic composition of the zygotes of the F2 plants can be easily obtained using the Punnett square as shown. As you already saw, there are four different types of phenotypes formed, and the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. However, 9 different genotypes result from the F2 hybrid, and the genotypic ratio is 1:2:2:1:4:2:1:2:1. Thus, from the dihybrid cross experiment, Mendel found that the gene combination of the progeny differs from the parental gene combination.
In next lecture, we'll discuss about law of independent assortment. Until that, goodbye.